Everyone, Sagan, sad to say, and welcome back to the Shocktober 8 Aftershocks, and what will be the final Aftershock video, because I've run out of time. And this should be the finale for the Quarry, as well, because I do not want to drag this into the 12 Days of Christmas, which, as of when this should be coming out, start tomorrow, so we gotta finish this. I'm all for having horror-themed content during 12 Days of Christmas, in fact, there will be some. But this is distinctly a Shocktober series. It's time to finish it. So, I'll apologize for taking so long to get this last episode out, but life happens, and I legitimately need some time to think about what I want to do with the game here, the decision we stopped at, and then shit got crazy at work, and I just was too exhausted to make videos for a while. But I'm back. Let's do this. So I've been thinking about this, and I've decided that, for better or worse, I'm not going to shoot Silas, because Silas isn't really the villain here. It's really the Hackett family. But it's one of those, like, everybody sucks here, like, nobody's truly an asshole.
That's why you've been hunting him. Silas,
I mean. Maybe Eliza. For locking up
every full moon for 6 fucking years.
Some hunter you are.
I'm not gonna shoot him. See what happens. Small chance I might F Alt F4, and we'll.
Jesus Christ.
Man.
We'll change that decision, but probably not.
Any sign?
Rattle lives. We're gonna stick with it.
Damn, I never saw any of this.
I didn't even know this was here.
Jesus Christ! I remembered at the last second that was coming, and that still scared the shit out of me.
Close. We must be close.
Did you both
see it too?
Kinda wish I hadn't.
Same. What is it?
Silas, the dog boy.
That must be it. Careful.
Fucking Jesus Christ.
I could do it.
Laura!
Do it.
He's just a boy!
He's responsible for so much death.
Says you!
Do it!
No!
Give me the gun.
Not gonna shoot him either. Oh! Oh! Oh shit! Well, fuck me. Is it too late to go back? Oh, she looks alive now.
Thought you were clever, didn't you? I knew my boy would be okay. With me watching over him, I'll never forget what you tried to do. I've been with you all night, you know. And I'm not about to stop just because the night's come to an end. No. Whenever you hear a noise in the dark, a whisper from the shadows, the breath on the back of your neck, that's gonna be me. I'll be there. Now, I'll never leave you. I'll never leave you.
Yeah, she looks completely alive there, where she's looked like a corpse the entire game. I got an achievement, Family Matters. I guess that's it, and everybody's dead. And I really kind of wish I could go back and let somebody live. I set out to let everybody survive. Well, I guess Mac's still alive. And so is Emma, but everybody else. Well, and Annie's still alive. Max secured the werewolf curse from Ryan Shark Chris Hagg with the show. He waits for Lara on a warrior fate. Others mauled to death by his werewolf brother. Chad was massacred by his werewolf son, Chris. Chris was killed when his favorite counselor, Brian, shot with silver. Or shot Constance's face off with the struggle for the gun. That's for fucking sure. Jacob was killed by werewolf Nick after Ryan eventually abandoned him in the Hackett's basement. Hackett's daughter Haley was shot by killed by Laura, who took him for the werewolf Chris. Werewolf curse was lifted from Kate and killed Caleb. Again, made it safe to Chris Hackett's surveillance room. And we survived the night in the safety of Chris Hackett's surveillance room. And survived the night, but took a refuge from Caleb in the kitchen. By the night, became Caleb, carrying all his effects by his lineage. We shot Caleb dead using silver shells. So that was Caleb we killed. Interesting. With a little hesitation, Silas, the white will slaughter Travis. Yup. Mark failed to shoot Silas. Ryan was killed in an instant. Good job. Laura was killed when she failed to shoot Silas and the curse. Yeah, I should have shot him. Should have shot him, and I really kind of want to go back and do it now.
Summer camp tragedy. Freak bear attack leaves several dead. What do you make of that, Anton?
I love that term, several. Like, the detectives are just, they don't even count the bodies. They're not like one, two, they're like one, two, three. Yeah, you know what, it's
oh, here's
several,
the podcast.
Several murders.
You know, it might be a tactic though. They can't give out that information yet. Sometimes detectives are notoriously difficult to solicit information from, especially when you go in saying, hi, I'm a paranormal expert.
I thought we'd done the whole Hackett's Quarry thing.
Not this Hackett's Quarry thing.
What was this, like 3 months ago? Old news, dude.
Anton, introductions first. We are Bizarre Yet Bonafide, the podcast of the paranormal. I'm Grace.
And I'm Anton.
And together, we explore the possibility of supernatural involvement in real life everyday occurrences.
And that's exactly what they are, real-life everyday occurrences.
With a shadow of spiritual, supernatural occurrences.
No.
Okay, so I hope you've got hat insurance, Anton, because I'm about to blow your mind.
Did you just ask if I had hat insurance?
Yes, it's responsible to insure those things which mean the most to you.
A hat.
Yes.
Okay, I know where your priorities lie. Go on.
Anyway, there actually is a real reason that we're coming back to Hackett's Quarry. There've been some developments, and I've sourced some information.
I remain skeptical, but I'm all ears. Under my hat.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Oh God, why? Why are you smiling? Stop it, I hate it.
Why? I had braces. I have to make use of them sometimes.
You do have very pretty teeth.
Thank you. That's something that a lot of podcast listeners might not know about me. So, it just so happens I've got someone on the inside. So today's episode is going to have a bit of a show and tell vibe to it.
Who do you know on the inside? The inside of where?
What?
You know someone on the inside?
Don't we all have someone on the inside? You know, an inner critic that says, stop doing a podcast. No one's listening.
You should listen to that voice, Grace.
Okay, well, what I really meant is, let's call it an anonymous donation. You know, we're not the only ones who flagged this as a bizarre situation. Someone actually reached out to us. They sent us a package.
Did you? You didn't open it. I don't trust anyone who listens to this show.
Oh, I couldn't wait to open it. Surprise!
Anonymous donation?
Okay, you've always promised me since day one of this podcast that if you could see true evidence, you will consider all options, right? Did you not say that?
I did say that, yes.
I mean, I know
knowing for a fact that we would never see any evidence, I did say that.
Okay, well, we've been sent information and we need to decide whether it's bizarre or bona fide.
Okay, fine. Let's do this. For anyone listening at home, we are about to open a package from a mysterious person who listens to this show. If you are the one who sent us whatever it is, congrats, you got us.
Sorry, the tape is just really, really... There's just so much tape on the package. Sorry, can you help me with this? Do you have, like, a key I could, like, slice at it with?
No, I don't want you to dull my key. Just use your fingers.
But just give me your fucking key, Anton.
No!
Give me your fucking key.
No! Get your own key.
Not like you lock your door.
Of course I lock my door.
What are you hiding?
What am I hiding? Do you not lock your doors?
No, I have nothing to hide.
You think that ghosts are real, but you don't lock your doors?
No, ghosts couldn't open my doors. They could walk through my walls, Anton.
Okay, you need to be more concerned with murderers.
Take a look. Apparently, they found another body.
Whoa! You can't just show me a picture of a dead body. You got to tell me before you're going to do that.
Okay, then let's take this over. Anton, can I show you a picture of a dead body?
No!
I can't work with that, Anton.
Okay, fine. Yes, it's a dead body. Okay, what is this? What am I looking at?
It's one of the hikers that went missing. Do you remember that?
Yes, that's the true part of the story.
Yeah, Ed Benson was his name. He was drowned in the lake.
Okay, drowned or was drowned?
Now you're getting grammatical.
I'm not getting grammatical. If you drown, you just went swimming and you drowned. If he's been drowned, then someone drowned him.
Well, then I think I implied precisely what I meant to imply. Now, of course, I can't verify this info, but...
Of course you can't.
What, do I have, like, a history of not verifying
my info? Yes, it's fake.
Okay, but I feel very strongly that he was drowned.
Okay, well, do the police know about this? Are the Hackett family suspects?
Okay, I like that you are getting into this. Here's the thing. The newspaper says this guy's still missing, right? He looks pretty fucking found in this picture.
Okay, yeah, I mean, he's not missing, he's right there, but
yeah.
Why? Why would they say he's still missing?
Because it is a conspiracy! A cover-up! Don't you see? They're all in on it.
Who is all in on it? The Hackett family?
The Hackett family, the North Kill Gazette. I told you I've been suspicious of them from the start.
Okay, so there's the one hiker, he's dead. What about the other one?
Anne Radcliffe? Still missing. Who knows how many bodies are still down there, though?
I don't know. This is pretty inconclusive. I'm sorry that the guy drowned, but this kind of seems like a big to-do over nothing.
Or is it a big undo of something, which is what a cover-up is?
Okay, you can't just twist my words like that.
Okay, so I anticipated your skepticism, which is why I saved this little gem for next.
Finally, you're gonna present me with some ghost ectoplasm.
Put out your ring finger. I've got a little gem to slide onto it.
What do you got?
Leaked photos from the hiker's camera. Photos that show them at Hackett's
Quarry.
Oh,
we did find the camera.
So maybe they.
But that card was on Jacob's body.
Their camera. It happens all the time.
Yeah, they dropped their camera whilst being murdered. And their bags were found there, too.
Oh, no way. Do you have a fake photo of them, too?
Oh, please.
Okay, so you have a picture of bags. These could be anyone's bags.
Well, they match up to the ones in their photos from their camera, and they have a monogram of their initials. I think, at least. Or it's water damage. I can't tell.
Yeah, okay. That's not nothing. I'll give you that.
So, we've got to talk a little more about the Hackett family.
Right, so these guys are like the heritage landowners, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Their great-great-great-grandparents were trappers who claimed the land way back when.
They just claimed it?
Yes, they did. They put their flag on it just like the man on the moon.
The Hackett family flag, right.
Well, apparently when they claimed it, they found quartzite.
Quartzite?
Okay, I was hoping you would ask. Fun fact, every building in the whole of New York is made of quartzite.
That's not fun or a fact.
Most of them are. But I digest.
Digress?
It was a pun. They dug the quarry and hit great heights of success before Septimus Hackett, classic bad guy name, the seventh son of the trappers, the number seven, has great supernatural powers, closed the mine down.
Okay, so then they only had the land to live off.
Yes, you say only, but this land actually spans acres. That's a lot of forest, a lot of unexplored darkness.
Ooh, okay, a great place to hide, to have all these dark secrets for this strange, reclusive family.
Mm-hmm. And this is where we start to get a little more into paranormal territory.
Okay, here we go.
Acres and acres of haunted woods.
If you say so.
Next, we have this empty vial thing.
Okay, the way you say empty vial makes me think that there was something creepy in there before.
Well, it's not half full, you little optimist, okay? We've got a photo from whoever my supernatural fairy godmother may be, but what are your initial thoughts?
Your godmother sends you vials full of this. I mean, it looks like there could have been blood in here.
My fairy godmother, not my actual godmother. She's estranged.
My God, what did she do?
It's actually what I did. But the important thing is, look at this vial and tell me it does not scream nefarious ritual.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like it could have had blood in it.
Yeah, something about this doesn't look like anything normal.
Yeah, well, it's a vial full of fucking blood.
Okay, Anton, what you see next pretty much confirms it.
That you're a crackpot conspiracy theorist, a loser?
Shit went down at Hackett's Quarry this summer. Real supernatch shit.
See, you always say things like this, and you're always overselling it.
You always have to oversell something to even sell it. That's capitalism, baby.
All right.
Okay, this is actual footage from one of the trail cams in Hackett Woods.
Oh, cool, a camera in the middle of the woods? Did they find a squirrel?
Be honest, if it was mounted on a mountain bike, you would watch that whole video.
Yes, of course. Is there a mountain bike involved?
No, but take a look anyways.
Okay. That is a bear?
That is a bear to you? There is no way that is a bear.
Okay, well, a skinny bear?
Okay, this could be some of the clearest footage of something like this I've ever seen.
Right, it's kind of blurry, though.
Blurry and convincing. Sometimes the truth can't be contained within the lines.
Right, yeah. And also, footage is pretty easy to fake. Technology is super scary.
Yeah, but what the hell were the Hacketts doing with footage like this anyways?
Huh. That's a good point. Weird little video of a skinny bear. Yeah, I don't know.
Again, you keep saying a skinny bear. Have you seen a skinny bear?
Yes, that's
bears
very sad.
Huge. Oh.
Yeah, polar bears. It's hard for them to find food sometimes. Don't feel too bad for them, though. They're nasty.
Okay, but putting the Hackett family aside for a moment, there's more to this. Are you ready for some real spooky shit?
I'm ready for real spooky shit. I don't know if you can provide it, but please try.
Don't get too freaked out.
I'll try my hardest.
Okay, do you want to hold my hand?
No.
Okay, do you need someone to comfortingly pat your back?
Please, just say what you're gonna say.
Do you want me to turn all the lights on so you don't—
I don't
get
want you
scared?
To do anything. I want you to say what you have. Okay, so what's this? What are we looking at now?
A photo by one of the counselors, Emma Mountebank, downloaded from her phone.
Oh my God, is this real?
Well, that is what we're here to discuss.
Okay, this looks chopped. I mean, doesn't it?
Okay, but if you downloaded photos from my phone, yes, they would all be chopped as well. There would be a filter on it to make my eyes look big and cheeks look pink. But I don't even think that has even any of those filters. Look at the eyes and tell me that's not real danger.
Yeah, it's weird.
Yeah, weird, bizarre, yet bona fide.
What the hell happened?
More than we are being told.
Yeah?
There's something else, too.
We have more evidence than this, simply.
Look at what happens when I put it through a negative filter.
Whoa! Okay, what is that?
It's her! The Hag of Hackett's Quarry! See? Full circle!
Oh, shit.
No. That could be anything.
Like what? Please, try to explain.
I don't know. What's that thing? There's this thing. It makes your mind. You see faces and stuff. There's people. There's Jesus shows up on toast every once in a while. This could be whatever.
Well, I don't need to hear too much more about your breakfast, but I can't believe that you're still questioning this. You're doubting your own cynicism now, though, I can tell. I can smell the doubt that you usually apply to other things on yourself. Pixar didn't happen, right? Well, Pix so did happen.
No, Pix you can fabricate. Experiences you can't. I need to... I would need to see the Hag of Hackett's Quarry myself.
Well, if you want to go to North Kill with me...
No!
I actually have a really good relationship...
I don't. Okay, I believe you.
Okay, but you know what? I have something that couldn't be fabricated.
Claw marks in a wall. I could make this right now.
Really?
Just find me a wall, I'll take a fork, and just go to town.
Wow. What an artisan.
Thanks.
Well, to me, this isn't actually... overtly supernatural, because it could have just been, you know, an animal or someone's angry parrot, but it'd be unfair not to discuss.
Why?
Because the audience has come to expect a certain length of the podcast, so we actually have to sometimes do a little bit of filler.
Yeah, that's true. We don't have much to talk about.
Well, whoever did reach out thought it was worth sharing.
There's a chance this is all just a prank, you know?
It was just a prank, Anton!
Who even are you? It's probably just some teenager who's making fun of you. It's probably that dude who came on and gave us a one-star review.
I would love to tell you that that's implausible, but a teenager making fun of me is probably the most familiar experience of my life. Moving on! How about this? Tell me this isn't freaky as shit.
Oh! Is that skin?
Skin? Fur? Whatever you want to call it, really.
Okay, it looks human. Is that a tattoo?
I don't think so. Or maybe a really bad one.
Wait. Is it?
Apparently, this belongs to whatever creatures supposedly caused all this.
Okay, do we have the actual thing? Did they capture it? Can I see it in the in its weird flesh, so to speak?
You want to touch the flesh.
I want to touch the flesh.
Well, fortunately, the person who sent this to me was smart enough to know that it would be dangerous to steal the actual evidence, not to mention they might suspect that you, Anton, would hide it away so as to sabotage this legitimate investigation.
Right, I am known for destroying evidence. Convenient that we can't see the real deal, huh?
Come on, man, you're desperate not to believe.
If there's reasonable doubt, you have to assume it's not real, Occam's razor.
But look at everything we've seen. Put it all together, objectively.
So, what we've got here, this could incriminate the Hackett family. Or, I guess it would have if they were still alive.
Wait, you believe it?
I don't know. At the very least, we should tell someone. The police should know, right?
Do you believe it? All of it?
No, not the supernatural stuff. I'm talking about killing those hikers. We've got a body, evidence they were there. This is real stuff, Grace. It's stacking up against the Hacketts. We might actually know something.
We got a whole flapjack stack of evidence.
Yes.
So what do we do?
Shut off the podcast and report this to somebody?
What? No! Anton, we finally have something going here. It's getting juicy.
Yes, we have something real. Actual people have actually died. This is actually crazy. Grace, you did it. Just take the win. Let's turn this off and actually report it.
No, say actually more.
Ass.
I keep thinking I'm going to see something in the corner of the screen here. Okay. I'm going to let the credits play through here. And then I'm going to see if I can go back and do that final decision over again. I suspect not. I'm going to see if we can do it, since this episode was a little short. Not counting the podcast. But if not, then that will be it, and we'll do a wrap-up. So, back with you in just a moment. Okay, let's see what happens here. Oh, I just got an achievement epilogue. Oh, I suppose that was the epilogue. Alright, so let's see. Says I'm on an epilogue though, so it may just replay the credits or may re-show, recap of everybody.
Summer camp tragedy.
Oh, that's neat. All right, let's do one final recap of all our paths then. So white whale. Laura, Travis, and Ryan ran Silas down after he attacked the car. Silas escaped once again because I didn't shoot him, which I now wish that I had.
Freak, bear. Yep.
Team building. Dylan and Caitlin went to the scrapyard to find a vehicle. Dylan and Caitlin were together to escape the scrapyard. Dylan and Emma found silver shells in the storm sensor. Abigail and Emma found their way into the lodge. Caitlin has Dylan company in the lodge. I decided to investigate the office door. And I killed Caleb with the silver shell. And we still don't have whatever this final path is. That's fascinating. I mean, that tells me there is definitely some replay value here. And knowing that there's a co-op option, I absolutely will try to bring this back possibly next year. With the Tesla, we might just do it as the weekly streams. I think that would be really interesting to dive into this again, take some different decisions, find more of these cards. I mean, look at all this. There is definitely stuff I did not find, and I felt like I was pretty thorough in what we did play. But obviously there were, you know, decisions made where there were different paths. They really should have got that fixed. Yes, indeed. Trail cam footage, which probably shows, one of the werewolves.
Attack leaves seven.
I guess I actually really like having the raven there on at the end. That's funny. Well, unfortunately, as it looks like, I cannot go back. Redo that decision. That is going to have to be it. So I'm sorry if that's a little anticlimactic, but I gotta say I enjoyed the hell of this game, and you can bet that I will bring this out again at some point, whether it's co-op or whether maybe next year. I just decide, you know what, let's play through it again. And this time, or that time, I will definitely know what to do with Silas. Not let him live. So, that is it. I hope you've all enjoyed watching The Quarry. I've enjoyed playing the hell out of these games. I love these games that Supermassive have been putting out, but this one is the first one in a while that has felt like a true sequel to Until Dawn, which is a game that I absolutely loved. So thank you all so much for watching with me. Sorry for the delay on this last part, but hey, here we are. Full series, full game done, for better or worse, and look forward to the 12 Days of Christmas, and we'll see more of this in the next Shocktober, I'm sure. So thank you all so much for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. Until next time, you stay classy, Internet. Plastic tubes and pots and pans, bits and pieces, and magic from the hands will make it weird science.